Anasema niite mkutano Uhuru Park, wa Kenya watakuja.
Kabisa, kabisa. Honorable, umemute na ulikuwa unaendelea vizuri. Anyway, ameenda. Nafikiri ni network mbaya. Okay, thank you. Morara, you want to respond to that?
Yeah. The time for Uhuru Park will come. I don't think Kenyans are angry enough. Kenyans who are on social media, they are angry, but the villagers are not angry yet. Let's build the mood. Let's build the mood pole pole. Then we will trigger it. I don't want us to fail like Nane Nane. This time round, if we shoot, we don't miss. Because these people are dealing with, they are so dangerous. If you shoot and miss, they'll finish you. As you must notice, there's something that is going on Facebook. I posted a certain thing and the PS for Lanza's answer. I posted a certain...
PS of Landers
amenijibu huko kwa Facebook kwa post fulani nimemake. I told them about some land. Government bought its own land for 2.7 billion.
Wow.
The land belongs to government, but government allocated it to a private person, issued him with a title, then bought it from that person.
Wow. Same like what happened in Embakasi, eh?
Yes, ndio nawaambia inaitwa Dupoto Darfur. Iko pale, kama mnajua Nairobi Inland Container Depot, ile ICD road yenye inaenda kutokea Eastern Bypass, kuna kakona pale kenye unaweza ingia na lami title. Kenya Railway said it needs the land for a project. So Kenya Railways bought it from them. This same Kenya Railways where the chairman is Duale's brother and Wetangula's son is on the board.
Wow. Just wow.
Now this
they
is
are
now
stealing everything.
Now this is all now what we say in a fucked up country.
And we allow these guys to finish another 3 years. What do you think they would have done by then?
They are going to kill us.
Trust me.
Three years is too much time. Too much time. Okay. Who is here who can be able to talk about Enda Russia?
Mm-hmm.
I'm the one who can talk about Enda Russia.
Yes, please.
What do you want to know?
You know, first of all, the neither Red Cross, the normal way they do is when a disaster happens, they account for the people, they take the list of the people who are involved in the tragedy, they put up a list, they match the list with the dead, the ones in hospitals and the ones who are alive, and then they say who is missing, and they create that list and they begin to give the support. This has not happened in Enda Russia. There is a claim. This claim has been made severally in some lives that about 100 parents are saying they don't know where their children are. Yet the government is saying only 21 died. So if 21 died, you remove 100, where is over 70 children? So Kindiki says everyone has been accounted for, but they have not given the list. Neither have they made an official release of that list. Anyway, that is the mystery that is surrounding the Enda Russia tragedy.
All right, so I've been to Enda Russia. I went there myself. I went up to the school. I also went for the memorial service of the parents. Very sad story. And this was a boys' school, and children were burnt to death. There are a few things that
are of interest to Kenyans who are listening to us. Kitu ya kwanza nataka wa Kenya wote wenye wanasikiza wajue kwamba Enda Russia mzima
sini umepotea kidogo. Rudi kwa mic.
Can you hear me now?
Yes, you're okay now.
Ah, yeah. Now, I've been to Endarasha. And I've been to Hillside School. And there are a few things that I want Kenyans to know. The first thing I want Kenyans to know is that when I was there, I realized that there is no hospital in the whole of Endarasha. There is no actually any hospital in the whole of Kieni West sub-county. What we have is a dispensary that has no medicine, no facilities. So even when the children were burnt, the children had to be taken all the way to Naromoru. Now you guys know how far Naromoru is from Endarasha. It is really far. Extremely far. So that's number one. Number two, we have a road over there. There's a road that was launched by William Samoei Ruto in 2018 with the MP Kanini Kega on that day, but that road has not been built from the section that goes to Charity, that goes to Embaringo. So the firefighters could not get there on time because the firefighters were coming from the nearest center, which is called Kiawara. Now, Kenya Power say that an electric fault did not cause it. They are investigating. But the truth is that there was a fire. And we want to believe that the fire was accidental, because you don't want to believe that it is an arsonist that burnt the dormitory. But now this dormitory is not safe for children by any standards, and the Ministry of Education shows that it has not been inspecting schools in that region, because the dormitory didn't even have a fire extinguisher, of which such a building that hosts human lives should paramountly have a fire extinguisher, but in this case, it did not have. Now, these numbers that you're hearing on television, personally, I want to say about what I know, not what somebody else knows or what I suspect. What I know is that there are two families, these I know personally, that are looking for their children, and I want to mention them here. 1 minute, I get their names. My personal assistant has sent me to them and sent me that list. Right. Yes, so here I have it. There is a man called Mr. John Mwangi. Mr. John Mwangi is a father of two at Endarasha. One child is accounted for, one is not. And there is a lady called Joyce Wangu. She's a grandmother to a 12-year-old son that she's not been able to trace. Those are the two people. But I know that people perish, people are burnt to death. Kenyans should not trust the government when it comes to numbers of dead people during tragedies. They always lie. And I don't know why it's necessary, by the way. I don't know whether it's to downplay the magnitude of the event. Sijui inakuanga maana ya kudanganya inakuanga ni gani kwa serikali kuhusu namba ya wale watu ambao wamepoteza maisha yao. A very good example is Shakahola. You know Shakahola, bodies were piling up every day. We got from 100 to 200 to 300. Then the government now sent people away. It didn't want to be accountable anymore. It didn't want anybody to know the truth anymore. And that is it. Oh, by the way, there's a lady who has commented here. She's called Catherine Ngatia. She says, my sister's friend's kid is also missing. His name is Brandon Roy Kinuthia. So you see, so there are more people coming up. So if you see even Kware, the government has all been accountable on how many people exactly died. Even time your protests, our shameless president said that he's not aware of any Kenyan who has been abducted or who has been killed. Very shamelessly, actually, in a whole town hall meeting. So this government, you cannot trust them when it comes to death. They always lie about death. I don't know why it is so important to them, but seemingly it's very important for them to lie. And that is the people we have.
And this is one thing that I wanted to ask. Did even the school, did they even follow the only protocols of the fire, of, let me say, of the civil department of putting on, what is it, fire exits, and has any investigation been done, such something like that? Because it's... It's like a whole okay, let me say, is it the no Ojo private schools at least? Is only shule zenye at least zinezekwa, what is it? Is only shule at least zinezekwa zinaangaliwata more than what? More than even the more than public schools. Right?
Yeah.
So kuna investigation yote imefanyika, watu wametraka kujua the cause of the fire mando aje, because hiyo maybe hiyo ni kitu mtu anaweza notice kama it's from the fault, it's from the electrical side, ama ni moto mtu alitaka kurusha ama ni aje. Yeah,
I think
yes.
What these people do, an investigation was done. Actually, kuna siku we visited with some people there, and what they are giving to the media is kama hii nini wanasema ya Hillsend. I have an information of Hillsend. Wanasema ilikuwa ni blackout ya stima ndiye iliangukia kitanda. Then that's what is in the media. That was the information that media ndio ilipiana. But ukiangalia in the sensical part, unaona hii kitu, it is like somehow planned, because during the day there was a blackout. So there was this, alafu all of a sudden, shule imechomeka, then some people are missing. And then the neighbors, they have no information of any child ametrisiwa, like amepatikana, amepotea, like, because they are children, you see. So like the information that the social media is giving in the news at times, it's not what is the ground for me, that kulingana na information yenye nimekuja kupata in the ground. And if you try to mention those things, uanze ku mention hizo vitu the yard, hata kama ni account yako, like they closed my video the other day, I mentioned something and then they just closed it.